I like how you make the picture. Nada más dice que tengamos cuidado con el chango. O sea, que hay chango. Ven a ver este
That's a tiger.
What?
It's a red one.
猴子，两只，白色的。哦，你看到了，有没有？妈咪看到，那边有个白色的。有看到的。有两只。还在看这个。你都没在看。你看一下。
actually didn't catch him initially, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think you saw that.
But then, honestly...
It was so funny, I was like...
Right, like
in any country they will do this.
Intelligent and inquisitive animals. They're also strong and agile.
Thank you. Paula.
Come on.
Thank you. 这个我不跟你讲，要去见他们。 长裙，你也不别 break out 了。哎，都喝到一个 break out。
Go go go！
你先要是平均水准五十米。
They will write the name. They will write the color.
To your food, and they will sit down next to you eating your food. Okay? Now, our animals will be all over the amphitheater. So please, if they are very close to you, please try not to reach out and touch them. Okay? You don't know them, and they don't know you, and you don't want to know what they can do to you. Alright? And last but not least, right after the show, when you're leaving the amphitheater, please do it in an orderly manner. Can we do that?
Yeah.
All right, now I've got one last question. Is everyone ready for the show? begin. All right, now, first of all, you picture this, right? The rainforest is home to an array of fascinating creatures, gigantic trees, colorful birds, and mysterious reptiles, right? So, why do you think a magical place like the rainforest needs to find space? Well, that's because the rainforest is the most endangered habitat on Earth. It has more than 50% of the world's plant and animal species. Now my name is Sunny, and I am going to bring you all to explore the rainforest from all around the world! First off, we're going to go all the way to South America, and we are going to meet our Koti Mandi. There you go. Now, Koti Mandi can be found in South America, and they are closely related to the raccoons, okay? Now, they do have this very long tail that helps them to balance when they climb trees and branches. Now, I'm sure you will notice why these two Koti Mandis do not look the same. Actually, they are the same. They are Koti Mandi. It's just that Nike here has thyroid, and that is where he lost all his fur. Otherwise, he's very, very happy and very, very healthy. Okay? All right now, next, still in South America, we are going to Colombia and meet two of the smallest species of primates that we have right here. I'm talking about our cotton top chamarines. Can you see them? We have two of them. Can you see them? No? Because they are not out yet. Okay. Here they come. Now, cotton top tamarins can be found in Colombia. Hold on, we're trying to get this Koti Mandi back. He's being mischievous a little bit here. Alright, now back to our cotton top tamarins. We have two of them and they are coming up. Can you see them now? Yes. As I say, we have two of them. Now the first one, his name is Juan Rico. The second one is Juan Esteban. You buy one, you get another one. Well, the reason being is that when they give birth, they always come in twins, okay? Now, I'm sure you will know why they are called cotton top tamarins, because of that cotton-like head that they have. Now, they can be small, they can be cute and adorable, but, they can also be very feisty. They have been seen fighting against primates which are larger than them, okay? Everybody say bye-bye Rico, bye-bye Esteban. All right, now from Colombia, let's go all the way to Africa. Let's go to the islands of Madagascar. Now some of you may have seen him in that same show called Madagascar. I'm sure you remember the cartoon Madagascar, right? And he likes to go like that. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Coming right now is our ringtail lemur. Now what you see out there is not King Julian from that cartoon. This is SD. The ringtail lemurs, they are usually very sociable animals. We notice when they move on the ground, they will have their tail high up in the air to make sure that the whole group stays in place. Now, this is a time where our animal will be up close and personal to you. So, if they are very close to you, try not to reach out and touch them, okay? There you go. Now we will show you how agile they can be, jumping from one point to another. Also, joining us will be BB. Now, this is a combination of father and son, okay? Now today we will also show you what they will do to prepare themselves before a sting fight. Now what is a sting fight? I will explain to you in a bit. First, watch this. Now this is what they will do to prepare themselves before a sting fight. They will wrap their tail against the sanglands on their wrist. Now the sanglands are located on the wrist. We're going to try that one more time with BB. Watch this. This is what they will do to prepare themselves before a sting fight. They would wrap their tail against the sanglands on the wrist, right? Now after they have done that, that's where the sting fight comes in. They would swing their tail against the other male, just like sword fighting. And eventually, one of the male will back off and run away, depending on how stinky that tail is. Now that is called a sting fight, okay? Everybody say bye-bye SB, bye-bye BB. Alright, now from Africa, let's come down closer. Let's come down to Southeast Asia. You are going to meet our Asian small clawed otter, the smallest species of otters in the world. And here they come. Now Asian small clawed otters, they have very good eyesight, both in and out of the water. Now as he swim across, watch closely. Now the back part of their body is actually coated with oil to make them waterproof. And the front part of the body, which the fur is slightly thicker, that is to keep them warm. Now, you can find otters in Asia. You can also find otters right here in Singapore. I'm sure some of you may have seen otters in Singapore, right? But, do not be mistaken. The otters that you see right here in Singapore are not of the same species. They are slightly larger than the one that we have right here. Now, not to worry. We are going to have another otter to come out to help us to recycle the tin cans and plastic water. And here he comes. There you go. This is wings, by the way. So very clingy to the... Okay, here he go. First, the tin can. Another tin can. The plastic bottle. And last but not least, the last plastic bottle. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, our Asian small clawed otter, the smallest species of otters in the world, together with his trainer, Hashim. Alright, now from the river shores of Asia, let's go to the airways of Africa. You are going to meet my next friend, very swift, very silent, and also very agile in the air. Talking about our trumpeter on me. Now, although they are called trumpeter hornbills, they do not play the trumpet, okay? It is the sound that they make that may sound like a trumpet, okay? Actually, they sound more like a baby's cry. Now, as he flies across, watch and listen closely how swift and how silent they can be. See that? That's how silent they can be. Now usually, the male is slightly larger than the female. And if you do notice, that cuffs over their bill. Now that cuffs, the larger they are, the more attractive they would be to the opposite sex, okay? Now we're gonna show you how agile they can be in the air. What we're gonna do is gonna throw a grip high up into the air, and we're gonna get Shaggy to catch the grip, okay? Hold on. Okay. All right, now watch this. This is how agile they can be in the air. Ready? One, two, and three. There you go. Isn't that fantastic? Now that's how agile they can be in the air. That is how they will just swoop down to catch even the flying insects on the go. Alright, now, my next friend, they are very, very shy creatures. You seldom see them during the day, and you seldom see them out in the open. Well, I'm talking about our hawk badger. See, they are so shy that they don't want to come out. Hold on. Let's see if they are coming out today. Now, hawk badger can be mainly found in Thailand, in India, and also Indochina. We have two of them. Let's see. Yes, and here they come. That's John and Marshall. Now ladies and gentlemen, if you are taking pictures, this is the best time for you to take pictures, because this is the only time you get to see them out in the open and out during the day. Now usually they will look for food at night in the dark, and they will only come out at night. There you go. It's John and Marshall. Alright, now that is cool, but let's slow things down a little bit right here, okay? Now my next friend has a pretty nasty reputation. Some people even call them evil, and they strike with no warning at all. They even give out this loud hissing sound. What am I talking about? Snakes. Now snakes loves cool and dark places, such as underneath your seat. Now look around you. Look underneath you. If you do see a snake, please raise your hand so that everybody can run away from you. I was just joking. Let me see if we can find one right here, okay? Whoa! Look who I found! Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is Brutus. Brutus here is our ball fighter. Now, ball pythons can be found in Africa, and the reason why they are called ball pythons is because when they are scared, they would coil themselves into the shape of a ball. There you go. Now they are also known as the royal pythons because in ancient days, Queen Cleopatra uses them on her neck or even her wrist as an accessory. How cool is that, right, ladies? Now, many people have this misconception that snakes are wet and slimy because of that glossy shine on their skin. Well, they are not, okay? They are actually smooth and dry. Well, if you have a chance to go down to our reptile garden, that's Ectopia, and if you do see a keeper holding on to a snake, you can approach them, have a feel of the snake, and you will know they are actually smooth and dry. Okay? Alright. Now, enough with the snakes. It's time to get serious. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we hope you have enjoyed journeying with these amazing animals and that you have come to appreciate how lucky we are to share Earth with them. But I need you to witness a sad truth. The animals you met today are fighting a losing battle in the wild because of us humans. We destroy forests, leaving them without food, without shelter, and without protection. But we can still make a difference. We can stop destroying their habitat. We can stop polluting our air and our waters. We can stop contributing to climate change. And we can end the illegal wildlife trade. Now we humans are the planet's greatest threat. But we are also their only hope. So let's take a stand, let's do our part to protect and respect nature and wildlife. It's time to bring this rainforest back to life. And with that, we have come to the end of Rainforest Fight Back. From you, we have enjoyed the show, but you guys have been fantastic. Take care, have a good day. Alright, now our birds will be making an appearance, so if they are very close to you, please try not to reach out and touch them, okay? They do bite, alright? With that, take care, bye-bye.
Okay, thank you. All the females. They just said on the thing, it says that all the elephants here are females.
Yeah. Tram coming. There's a tram. ride and ride.
Conservation work and breeding programs in zoos around the world. Many babies are conserved right here at the Singapore Zoo.
Come on.
Come on.
So wala siya much space.
open. Book open.
Do you see any mom? Do you see any mom? 爸爸一起动吗？
那边呢？哦，你不要把我一个人送。你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？你？
Bambi!
Wait, no, it's a different one.
Find the bed. Oh.
tengah curi. Muka tak bersalah.
Oh. Saya tak panda.
Thank you.
그렇지. 네, 여기서 일로 가서.
trên trống không? Trên trống sạch sạch thôi.
A ver, aquí está este animal.
Okay. Para allá.
Thank you.
拉河带水啊，好多山呢，也是。
第今天。